No, this is not a jacket potato or a lychee or an orange peel. What you're seeing is what is known in plastic surgery as a capsular contracture. One of our recent TikTok videos got over 2 million views and the comments section just blew up. So many of you had many great and interesting questions. In this video, I want to clear up some of the confusion around implants and some of the complications that can arise, especially when it comes to capsular contracture. Let's start with the basics. Surrounding every implant, there's a very thin layer of capsule that is formed. And in the vast majority of patients, it stays and remains this way. But a capsular contracture is when that thin layer starts to thicken and harden and tighten, and it may cause distortions of the breast, may cause upward, lateral, downward, inward movement of the implant itself or the breast tissue, and it may even cause some discomfort. Now, let's talk about some of the comments in there. Some of them were like, wow, this makes me never want to have implants. This happens to everyone. Can't wait to get mine out. Even a few people were tagging a content creator, Bells Lindsay, who looks like she recently had breast augmentation. So let's set the record straight. No, this has not happened to everyone who has breast implants. In fact, most people with implants will never experience this. And with newer technology implants coming out, improved surgical techniques, proper post-operative care, these have all contributed to reducing the risk of these capsular contractures from ever happening. So although capsular contracture is a known complication of breast augmentation and something that we do discuss in our consultations, it is a very uncommon effect. What other questions have you seen that we may have missed? Or do you have questions of your own? Drop them below. We're always listening and happy to clarify. So let's talk about how to minimize this from happening. While no procedure is completely risk-free, there are certain steps that we surgeons do during the procedure to help minimize these complications. For one, surgical technique matters. The no-touch approach is really where we're using funnels and avoiding touching the implant itself with our gloves. Again, minimize contamination of the implant. Sometimes it's these little contaminants that might stimulate the immune system to form thicker capsules. Proper post-op care is also critical, so listen carefully to your surgeon's instructions and follow them to the T. And yes, not all implants are created equal. Certainly with newer technologies, and we're always constantly studying the risks associated with any given implant, and we're always helping to choose the right implant based on some of these risk characteristics for our patients. By taking a personalized approach and being proactive, we can help minimize these complications from occurring and help our patients enjoy a long-lasting and natural results. To recap, capsular contracture can be one of the complications that occurs after breast augmentation, but it is not something that everyone will experience. This particular case stood out because of how severe and rare the situation is, which is one of the main reasons it went viral. We're happy it started a conversation and even more excited to share and educate more about capsular contracture. If you currently have breast implants, it's not a bad idea to just get the imaging around your implant every 2 to 3 years to make sure there's nothing like a rupture. But also, if you're experiencing symptoms like firmness that's different from one side to another, changes in shape or discomfort, please reach out to your plastic surgeon, or we're also happy to help. Use our link in the description below. If this video helped clear up any confusion, please like and subscribe to our channel. If you're considering breast augmentation, check out our playlist, which covers everything from consultation to recovery. Thank you so much for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video.